Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how I make chili chicken. This chili chicken is one of the most popular in Indo-Chinese style chicken appetizer or a starter. This delicious chicken recipe is very popular in Chinese restaurants, but these days you will see this on Chinese food cart on every road. But with this easy recipe, you can make it at the comfort of your home according to your own taste. You can serve this chili chicken with some fried rice or vegetable noodles. You can make this as a dry version or a gravy form. Both taste equally good. So let's check out the ingredients. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and click the bell icon. If you like this recipe, do give a thumbs up. Click the like button. If you have tried the recipe, do leave a comment in the comment section below. So let's get started. Here I have taken two breast pieces, that is around 350 to 400 grams of boneless chicken cubes, 1.5 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, salt as per taste, 1 teaspoon of pepper powder, 1 teaspoon of green chili paste. This chicken should be quite spicy when you fry, otherwise it will be very bland. 2 teaspoons of vinegar, 1 egg, give it a nice good mix. I usually fry one piece before I start frying the whole thing, because if the chicken is bland, then the whole recipe is flop. 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder. This is just for color. This is optional. Add around 2 tablespoons of corn starch or corn flour and 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. I usually mix both, but if you like, you can use any one. Don't add everything together. Mix it little at a time. If you feel you require more, just add accordingly. Now in a bowl, take a little water, add 2 teaspoons of soya sauce. Then add 1 teaspoon of chili sauce. Then next you can add 1 teaspoon of green chili sauce. Give it a mix. 1 teaspoon of vinegar. This solution should be salty, a little spicy, a little tangy. Add 1 tablespoon of corn flour. Mix it well. See that there are no lumps. At this point of time, try to taste it and see. Now you can fry the chicken in oil. Add individual pieces slowly and fry. They should be crisp and cooked fully. Don't keep the flame on high, otherwise they tend to brown very quickly and the inside won't be cooked, because it doesn't cook much in the gravy later on. Remove it on a plate and keep it aside. Once the chicken is fried, kids tend to eat 1 or 2 pieces. This is 3 green chilies, white of the spring onion, green leaves, ginger and garlic. this is capsicum and onions cut into cubes. This is the green of the spring onions. Now take 1 tablespoon of oil, add the chopped ginger, that is 3/4 piece ginger, around 8 to 10 garlic chopped, fried for a minute. Don't burn them, nor they should be soft. Usually in Chinese cuisine, the vegetables retain their crunch. They shouldn't get mushy and soggy. Add the spring onion, green and white together. Fry it just for a minute. Then you can start adding the other vegetables. Just till the raw smell goes. Now the flame should be on high, otherwise the vegetable will start releasing their water. Fry the capsicum and onions also on high flame just till they become a little transparent. Add the solution of vinegar, soya sauce, chili sauce and water. Give it a good stir before adding, as the cornstarch tends to settle at the bottom. Give it a nice mix, and once the liquid begins to boil, you can add the fried chicken pieces. At this point of time, check out for the salt and spice. If you like it more spicy, you can increase the chili paste, or you can add a little pepper powder. Add all the chicken pieces, give it a nice good mix, and you are done. Don't overcook it, otherwise the chicken will tend to get very soggy. Garnish it with the chopped spring onion leaves. This should be had hot and immediately once it is done. Don't keep it for long, otherwise it will turn mushy. Just give a nice good mix and switch off the flame. I hope you like this recipe of mine. Do give it a try. I'm sure you too will enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you like this recipe of mine, do give a thumbs up. Do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. So my dear friends, hope you have enjoyed this quick and yummy recipe. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye, see you soon with a new interesting recipe.